I always like to add a little bit of water to the surface of the canvas before I start. You notice I wet the brush because I don't want it real dry. And I'm just going to put a smooth white coat of paint over the entire canvas area. I'll speed this up and cut out the boring stuff for you. Now, I'm going to add some background atmosphere to my urban setting. This process works best, putting it over that white paint that's slightly fresh, because we want some blending, but not too much. This is a very expensive artist painting blade. Not really. It's a putty knife from the hardware store. Thank you. Using the same process, I'm going to use a little deeper color just to add some depth to it. Just place a couple of marks on the canvas so I know about where level is for my city scene. The simplicity of this painting is what's important to me. That's why I'm only using black and white for the city itself. I'm painting with a spatula here. I like the way it holds onto the paint. Using the white and the black, remember that buildings are not flat, so be sure and add some dimension. Imagine an atmosphere clouded with dust, and then imagine buildings that are near and far and large and smaller and of all different styles. add some abstract details to signify windows and ledges. I imagine the city is sitting on a waterfront, so let's add some reflections. And you might be thinking, that doesn't look like water, but remember, this is abstract. It's only going to represent. Thank you. let's add some fog and dust. Every city has this at the ground level. I'm just adding more textures now to give it more depth. using a sponge with a little more water next to add a little more texture. Because we have so much light, we also need some dark. And this adds some foreground. Thank you. just keep adding texture and detail until I feel that it has enough character. I paint in between the canvas pieces so that the image carries around the edge.